Alright, Shalom.
Shalom.
Giving all praises to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Makar Kodash. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone that rule impeccably well. And Shalom to the sincere Akim that's pushing his truth in sincerity, man. You know, with hopes of being delivered, man. Right, just on our way to camp, it's the brother Yakanan. I got a brother. And you know, we're on our way to camp, but Spirit has just permitted us to get into a video, man. You know, because we're in a very serious time right now, very serious climate. There's a lot of things happening in the truth. There's a lot of things happening in the world in general, man. So, you know, it's about maintaining this spirit of diligence, man, and being, you know, of a spirit of being apt to teach. And taking, you know, every advantage that you, you know, physically can and spiritually can to push this word, man. You know, now we just want to get into a topic regarding, you know, you can't run out of things to talk about in this truth, man. Right? It's literally impossible for you to run out of topics and to you know, run out of subject matters, and you know, the material alone on this devil, man, the so-called white man, who are the biblical Edomites, the material on them alone, you know, is grand, man. You know, the scriptures say in the book of Revelations that his sins have mounted up to heaven, man, roughly paraphrasing.
I've got that if you want, man.
Can't.
This is Revelation 18 and we'll start from 4. It says, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye have, and that ye receive not of her plagues, but her sins have reached unto heaven.
God.
And the Most High hath remembered her iniquities.
God. So it says her sins, right, have reached unto heaven, man. Right? So what does that mean? There's so much things that this race of people have done, these Edomites have done upon the planet Earth. There's so much wickedness, right, that is piled up unto heaven, man. Right? So regarding material to do videos on, using Esau as an example alone, right? You can, it's never ending. There's always things coming out about the wickedness that he's done, right?
I got that right here.
Can't.
So Isaiah 47 and 3 says, thy nakedness shall be uncovered, yea, thy shame shall be seen.
Can't.
I'll take vengeance, I'll not meet thee as a man.
That's it, man. Nakedness uncovered. It also says in I believe it's Jeremiah, that I will make Esau bare.
Yeah.
You know, so that's another one right there, man. You know, so that's what the Lord has done. He's made this devil bare, and he's uncovered his secret places, as it's going to say in the scripture. So what does that mean? That means there's so much content for you to go into and to bring out regarding this man. You know, there's a lot of content, man. Right? We cannot run out of content. It all has to be brought out, man. It's all part of prophecy. It has to be brought out. People have to see how much of a devil this so-called white man is, man. Right? There still are people that have got to come across things that's going to bring them into this truth from finding out certain things, man. And we're the ones, we're the spiritual news reporters that the Lord has set up to bring these things out.
Yeah.
You know?
So Jeremiah 49 and 10 says, but I have made Esau bare. I have uncovered his secret places.
Uncovered his secret places, man. You know, so all his dwelling places, his devil being uncovered. You got this thing on the internet we were watching with the brothers the other day, yesterday night, Salakia, with these two little kids basically talking about how they got molested and got made to do child sacrifice and all that kind of stuff. Now, hey, man, that's out there now, man. People can go and look at that on YouTube, man. That's part of the Lord making Esau bare and uncovering his secret places. So all that nastiness and demonic activity he does in the dark, the Lord is now bringing it to light, man. He can't hide himself no more, man. You know? And it's our job, again, to bring that information out, man. And do videos on such things, man. So there's not a lack of content we're ever going to have while we're in this truth. The Bible is a big book, man. We've got to remember the Bible is a history book of the world, man. You know? And I was saying the other day, I bought this dictionary, right? And when you go to the back of the dictionary, it gives you a timeline from the beginning of the earth up to that current point, which was 1973, I believe.
Yeah.
And you know what's in there? Pure biblical events in the beginning. Which shows you that even Esau, the so-called white man, regards biblical history as actual fact.
Yeah.
You know? He had to include it in there, because where are you going to start? Where are you going to start, you know?
Yeah. goes on to say, I have uncovered his secret places.
God.
He shall not be able to hide himself.
God.
His seed is spoiled, and his brethren and his neighbors, and he is not. Right. So your main point there was, you know, Lord has made Esau bear.
Mm.
You know, Lord has made it such that we all know all the wickedness that he's done. We're coming out.
Yeah.
We'll profess it. Right, we'll speak it upon the mountains, even upon the rooftops.
Mm.
But what does it say in Isaiah 6? You have people who just won't get it, man.
God.
Rather, who won't want to get it. Their eyes are closed,
yeah.
And they don't want to see it. They don't want to. You know, we'll start breaking it down to them, right? But that's on them, right?
Yeah.
Because the Lord, you know, in Isaiah, you know, asks, "Oh, how long shall this be?" And then the response is, look, man, these guys will be sleeping up until it's the time of destruction, man.
That's right.
You know, lest they basically come into the fold.
And it also said in that scripture, he will not be able to hide himself.
Yeah.
Because the Lord has given us what? He's given us the unicorn. He's given us the internet, which really the main purpose of that was to expose this devil, man.
Yeah.
And to wake up the elect that needed to hear this gospel through the internet. Right? Those are the two main reasons that the Lord set that up, man, which is a beautiful thing. But that's why Esau says that. I forgot who the actual guy was that said it. He made the statement that we should never have created the internet, man.
Yeah.
But it's all through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua.
Right, because Esau's been able to use that that internet for psychological warfare.
Yeah.
So at the time he was like, look, man, yeah, you know, it's a brilliant idea. We can control the people with this shit.
Yeah.
Right, but what he didn't count on was the Lord actually was that one hijacking,
yeah,
right, the internet,
to
teach his word, man,
yeah,
right under his nose.
That's it, man. That's why the scripture says he will not be able to hide himself, man.
Yeah.
Because now this information is just out there like a great flood, you know, and it's just out there, and then you can access the information, you can access the archives of this devil's wickedness, you know, through all the time and ages, you know, from the beginning of the world, man. You can just access it at any time and read how demonic it was. You can read how he treated the Native Americans, man. You can read how they tried to starve them with the buffalo, what you posted in the chat, by killing off all the buffalo. That's a really, these are wicked acts, man.
Yeah.
Right? And those are things you can do videos on, man. You know? You can actually do videos on Esau for a whole year, every single day.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Continuously, just doing videos about his wickedness, the things that he's done, the legislations that he's broken, you know, being a fork tongue. All of these things can be reported on, man, because it all helps in revealing the devil, man. You know, and that's our job. And then you got our history as a people, like you got the Israelites. There's so much information out there still to be uncovered to this day, of information regarding us being the true biblical Israelites, man. Right? What you got to do, you just got to search, man. The scriptures say, blessed is he that readeth, man.
Yeah.
You know, that's primarily talk about the scriptures.
Yeah.
But, you know, it can also stand for just reading into history as well, man, because you're going to find things.
Those are all part of the scripture.
Exactly.
Well, that's all part of the scripture, man, because apostles always say, hey, you got to get into them words. The scriptures themselves won't get into words, but you got to go into the etymology to hear that.
That's it.
So you have to have an understanding of history, right? Because it all helps shape it into your mind, what was going on at particular times, this and the other, and it all helps link the scriptures up together.
Yeah.
Right. I got a piece that's Isaiah 62:6. Right. It says, "I have," and I'm sorry, and that reading is talking about what do you call it? Things that correspond with the scriptures, man. Not that geezer that came up a couple of weeks ago talking about, you know, a book of. Enoch and all of that.
God.
Right, because they don't correspond with the scriptures.
That's it. Right? Anything that corresponds with the scriptures, you're permitted to bring it out, man.
Yeah.
The spirit. Because if it's in conjunction with the prophecies and the things spoken of, that's how we know the Apocrypha belongs in the Bible.
Yeah.
Because it corresponds with the rest of the books in the Bible.
Exactly. And even what was that? I forgot the next one I said. It was Isaiah 62:6. Oh, one more thing. That word there, read it as well. You look into it. Remember looking into it a while back. One of it means understand. Blessed is he that understands. Because many can read.
God.
Right? You know, you got all of these guys in universities right now reading a whole load of stuff, but they don't understand it, man.
That's it.
Right? They don't. Because if they understood, they'll realize the majority of the shit they're being taught is bullshit.
Yeah.
Right? But, what was it? Understanding, man. It's all about the understanding of things, man. Right, so Isaiah 62:6, I have set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem. which shall never hold their peace day nor night. Ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silence.
That's it, man. Hey, that's a commandment. Us that make mention of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, keep not silence, man. So anytime, again, we get a chance to push this gospel, we're supposed to do it, man. You know, we're not supposed to, consider these things. It's supposed to be second nature to us, man, preaching this gospel, man. And like I keep saying, you really got to preach it like your life depends on it. Your actual life, your salvation, your spiritual well-being depends on preaching this truth, man.
Okay.
You know, if the Lord has given you that luck to do, then you really do have to do it with all your mind, body, and soul, man. You know, that's not a joke. That's a heavy thing. It's a heavy office, man. You know, there's certain jobs you can get out there for Esau. If you don't put your all into that job, he's going to fire you. You know, and we'll fight.
Yeah, and those are the jobs that pay the most. And this is the exactly. best paying job.
Those are the jobs that pay the most, man. It's some bosses will actually tell you gotta sell your soul to that company, man. You know, there's a figure of speech, they'll actually tell you that. Just to mirror the kind of work effort you're gonna have to do to maintain in a job.
Yeah.
You know, I've had a boss tell me that before. Mm. If you want that position, you're really gonna have to sell your soul. You're not gonna have a life. Mm. You're gonna be working from 9 to 9.
Yeah.
You know, you're gonna be doing hella overtime, you know. And you're going to have to make a lot of sacrifices. You're not going to see your family. I've been in situations like that, man.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to quit. You know, you can't do that. You got to do stuff like that for the Lord, man.
Yeah, exactly.
The Lord is only worthy to be doing that kind of work effort for, man.
Yeah.
You know?
Can't, because that's a big thing in them, like, 5-6 figures, in those 6-figure salary jobs.
Yep.
Of them just owning your life, man.
Yeah.
Remember, I met a chick that worked at one of those major, what you call it, accountancy firms, PwC.
Yeah.
The story she was telling me, man, bro, she was just slaved, man. She was a complete slave.
God.
Right, but we're complete slaves to Yahweh Shai.
That's it.
You know?
Yeah.
She was telling me how, like, one day she started working like 8, didn't finish work, 8 a.m.
Yeah.
Didn't finish work till like midnight, man.
Yeah.
Right? But she's happy because she's getting paid. And that's the same with us. We should be happy because the Lord is going to reward us for our work.
That's it.
And the worst thing about it is we're doing what we're supposed to be doing anyway.
Yeah. Still call yourselves unprofitable.
Exactly.
Servants, man.
God,
bro. Yeah.
This is Sirach 39 from the top. Says, but he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High and is occupied in the meditation thereof, we seek out the wisdom of all the ancient and be occupied in prophecies.
God.
Right, so you be keeping your mind in law, right? Occupied in prophecy. What's one of the ways you're occupied in prophecy? You're watching, you're saying, yo, what's happening there? Oh shit, that's happened, but that links up with this prophecy.
Yeah.
Right? This this event over there, that links up with that prophecy.
Yeah.
And then when those things happen, you bring it out.
God.
Right, and it talks about occupied in the meditation thereof, basically meaning that it's something that's always on your mind, right? Because like the Bible is saying, there's certain life events, right? When you're out and about in the matrix, well, you see certain. I've done it many times, right? Where I'll see certain things happening in the world or in places where I'm at, and I'm like, yo, man, that's worthy of a video, man.
Yeah.
You know, just because someone's in the world doesn't mean they can't drop some gems on you, man.
Of course, can't. Yeah, you gotta even utilize certain conversations.
Yeah.
You know, in my particular job, sometimes I find myself speaking to some people you would never get a chance to speak to in your normal lifestyle, man.
Yeah.
And you can learn things. On many occasions I have learned things, man.
Exactly.
You know, because it's all experiences, all different ways of life. You see how people think, you see how their upbringing was, that you compare it to yours, shit, man, that's a big difference right there.
Yeah, hey man, I've got a research topic that I gotta do from a conversation I had with one guy at my workplace, something about the Gulf of Tonkin, right, which led up to, if I remember correctly, the Vietnam War and all of that, how was another false flag.
Yeah.
Right, so that's a research topic that I got to do.
Yeah.
I wouldn't have known about it had I not had conversation. And that's the thing, you got to understand, it's the Lord that puts these people in your life, that makes the, you know, the Lord directed the steps.
Yeah.
So if these guys are around you, man, that means the Lord has them around you for a reason.
Mm.
And you're just going to take the gems that you can. Don't get me wrong, some people are just straight up demons. But even then there's videos to do from that,
exactly.
man.
Exactly, he's a straight up demon, man. That's a video right there. can't.
You know, you have a proud ass demon Jake that you work with. Like, look, man, our people are proud.
Yeah. God. Yeah, that's right, man. That's right.
Hey, man, things of the world that Jake be doing these days, man.
Yeah.
you know, geezer might work with a geezer, straight up nigga, man. The nigga's telling you some wicked shit that Jake be doing in mass. You're like, what the fuck is this shit?
Yeah.
And you look it up, you're like, oh man. You put on the camera, you're like, yo man, yo, Jake is through.
Yeah. Hey, for real, man, because you hear things, man. You know, so that wicked nigga just gave you inspiration to make a video.
Yeah.
That's going to edify, you know, the hope for Relax, man.
Exactly. Make all of us say, man, fuck this place. We need to get out of here.
Come on.
Like, man, when I found out that Jake in mass be licking assholes nowadays, man.
Yeah, it's a big thing.
And then you're just there like, wait, what?
Yeah.
What's going on? Because I was discussing with this brother yesterday, man. I ain't heard no rap video, rap songs talking about, yeah, man, I lick ass.
Yeah.
This, that, and the other, oh, licking ass is so good. There wasn't, I don't remember a psyops pushing Jake to lick ass. So I'm just there like, what? Since when?
Yeah, when they are, niggas just be doing that, man.
Yeah, and then you hear that shit, you're like, man, Jake is blue. We need to get the fuck out of here, man. Because then what's next?
Yeah, what is next, man? I mean, you can't, you know, it doesn't get deeper than that, really. You licking ass.
Yeah.
That just shows that the level that Jake is on right now, man.
Yeah.
We're on such a low vibration, man, the logo will be coming back soon, man.
Next, Jake will be proper into that proper kinky stuff Esau's into. Oh, yeah. Shit on me. Piss on me.
Getting kicked in the face. You know, all that kind of stuff, man. Because, yeah, Esau's, he's been at that level from the beginning, man. You know? That wasn't even a gradual process for Esau. He just came out like that.
Yeah.
You know? But our people are reaching to that level of wickedness.
Yeah.
You know? So, yeah, man. There's endless topics out there, man, to be covered, man.
Yeah.
You know, the Bible is a big book. You know, history in itself. You research history, research this devil, research all the things he's done to all the nations upon the earth. Not even just our nation, just all other nations.
Yeah.
You know, Hiroshima and Nagasaki.
Yeah, yeah.
That's
a
video too. It's not our nation, but it's the wickedness still.
Hey, but it's our slaves, man.
That's it. You're fucking up our slaves.
It's our slaves. That's our property, man. You know, imagine, you remember when you was young, some guy came to your house, started trashing all your toys, man.
Yeah.
You're gonna be pissed, mate. But man, one more time I see that motherfucker, man. God. I'm gonna fuck that nigga up.
God.
Yeah, man.
Oh, man. All right, man. I ain't got nothing else to cover on this one, bro.
Yeah,
if you got anything else to say.
Can't. Nah, I'm good.
All right, man. You know, Lord willing, you know, that was edifying. We just wanted to put it out there, man, because, you know, we're in serious times.
Mm.
And, you know, we gotta keep pushing this truth, man. You know, don't stop, man. Don't stop pushing. There's a lot of information out there to bring out that still hasn't even been brought out, man. Mm. So, with that said, you know, Shalom.